Hi, folks. My name is Justin. I guess we'll just go to the graphics. Hi, folks. You might notice my co-host is not here today. Vash is not in town. Vash is actually in San Diego at Comic-Con this weekend. In fact, he was just on Rotten Tomatoes last night with one of his pictures. We're very happy for him. He's having a blast of a time, I'm sure, and when he comes back, we'll talk all about it. However, he failed to mention when he was leaving this week, so we didn't get a chance to shoot a video when he was in San Diego, and he said he left a series of clips with the intern that will be his representation of how he thinks he will enjoy the movie this week. It's kind of exciting. I really don't know how this is going to play out, so I guess, Vash, can you start with whatever your first clip is?
We're still doing an intro. Use one of the last intros. Use all of them.
Okay. I guess that was a bad start. Today we did Red 2. The sequel to Red, Retired and Extremely Dangerous. Very much a summer popcorn movie, Vash.
This movie was awesome. Tell me you didn't like it. You can't tell me you didn't like this movie. This movie was so fun.
Okay, that worked. Great. I enjoyed the movie too. Very much is that fun summer action film, good comedy.
And as usual, you're not going to let me talk.
Okay, I don't really know when you're going to talk because we didn't time this out together.
Bruce Willis. I do like Bruce Willis. He's given us great movies like Look Who's Talking, the first Die Hard, Armageddon, which no matter how many times I've seen it, whenever I pass TNT and it's on, I watch it.
Yeah, the movie also has Dame Helen Mirren and John Malkovich and Mary Louise Parker and Anthony Hopkins.
And as usual, you're not going to let me talk.
Okay, I don't know. This is not planning out very well. Do you want to talk about something else then, I guess?
I felt like I kind of wanted North Korea to take over so that I could beat them myself.
North Korea really has no bearing in this movie. There was a Korean guy, but he's from South Korea. That's...
Who would you want to take over?
I don't know who. I don't want anyone to take over, Vash. This is not making...
You know who we want to take over is Italy, so we can have some good pasta. Italy.
We can still get pasta even if Italy doesn't...
You do realize that if cows decide to take over, we are done for.
Cows?
They're so heavy and hard. Like, if they attacked us, we're done.
Really?
Could you imagine cows running through here right now? We couldn't take down four cows.
No, I'm not worried about cows because they're freaking cows.
Well, no, I figured if cows are going to be at a point where they can try to rise up, they'd be, like, more aggressive.
More aggressive cows? Why did you pick that for a clip for this movie, Vash? This makes really no sense at all.
I love Mother Russia.
Okay, Russia. No, that's great. They actually went to Russia. That's good. Thank you.
I would finally like to get a chance to talk. You never let me talk on this thing.
I feel like that's all you're doing right now is talking while I'm trying to come up...
Like all franchise enders, they went to Russia.
You think the franchise is over because they went to Russia?
Police Academy 7, Assignment, Mission to Moscow, Rocky 4...
No, they made a Rocky 5 and a Rocky 6. Rocky Balboa was a 6 movie, technically.
GoldenEye.
The Bond movie? They made like 20... They're all in Russia. It's Bond.
The Sum of All Fears.
Did they even go to Russia? Oh, no, I guess they were. But actually, they're making a Jack Ryan movie this year with Chris Pine. So that...
Quantum of Solace.
Okay, again, Bond movie. That's a ridiculous answer. We reviewed a Bond movie last year. Go to this. A terrible topic.
Why don't we ever do anything I want to do? You know, like my ice cream and used tires idea. You never use that.
What are you talking about?
Remember, in improv, you never say no.
No, I'm not saying no. I'm saying I have no idea what you're talking about.
You can't do that. You have to act like we already know.
What? How does this even make any sense? Why did you pick these clips, Vash?
Siri, tell me how Justin is wrong again.
I'm not being wrong. What? I'm really not liking how this is working right now.
And now we take you live to Justin being a douchebag.
I'm not being a douchebag. I'm just, apparently you need to learn the basics of improv. Two people need to be in the same room.
Well, look who graduated from the University of Fancy.
I want to punch you in the face right now. This is the worst idea you have ever come up with for this show. I'm gonna wait for you then.
Say something.
Are you f***ing kidding me? All right, fine. I will review the movie. You're going to let me review the movie, maybe? I don't even know.
That's right.
I'm going to take that as a yes, then. Fine. I would give this movie probably a 3 out of 5. I mean, it was fun to watch. I enjoyed it. You don't have to go to the theaters. If you saw Red 1 and you liked it, totally go to Red 2. It's worth your time. It's just as good. If you haven't, enjoy the first one on Netflix. Enjoy. I'm sorry that I seem so that way. It's not because of the movie. It's because of this stupid-ass episode. I don't want to do this anymore. Vash, do you want to review?
I don't know what the hell I said.
I don't know what that means, so fine. I'll review for you. Vash would probably give this a 3 out of 5. No, you know what? Vash would come up with a whole new stupid category for no reason. And his category is going to be, I don't know, I had too much ramen today because I'm so poor, yet I need to eat something. So I called Justin and made him bring me food and we're watching the movie and it was fun. How's that fun?
I'm never speaking to you again.
You know what? I only wish that was the truth.
Say something.
Wow. Please subscribe to our page. Please feel free to watch a previous video where we're actually in the same room and can work off of each other, and this isn't the most asinine video on the face of the planet. I cannot believe I let this happen. Thank you for watching. Please come back again.